In this video, I will be reviewing a $399 15.6-inch laptop that boasts impressive specs and build quality. Will this laptop take the crown of the best budget laptop of 2020? Let's find out! This is the latest model of ASUS VivoBook 15, and it is powered by Intel's 10th generation Ice Lake CPU. So at the time of making this video, this laptop was selling for $399 on Amazon. Now, since the price tends to fluctuate, please check out the links that I have put in the video description below for the latest price and availability of ASUS VivoBook 15. To find out if this laptop is any good, I will put VivoBook 15 through 10 rounds of grueling test. So without further ado, let's get started. While looking at VivoBook 15, I get the feeling that ASUS took inspiration from their premium ZenBook line of laptops. So this is a well-crafted laptop and it comes in 5 different colors. So my review unit, it's slate gray in color and it has this understated professional vibe. VivoBook 15 is made from ABS polymer, but ASUS has given it a faux aluminum finish, which makes it far more premium than its price. The top lid has an anodized aluminum finish, which is non-glossy, and it contrasts nicely with the glossy ASUS logo carved in chrome. When you open the laptop, you are greeted with a dark black keyboard sitting on a faux anodized aluminum base. The palm rest has a polished, smooth finish which feels very comfortable while using the keyboard and the trackpad. So the underside of this laptop is made from polycarbonate and it is matte black in color. The laptop chassis feels very rigid and I did not experience any creaking or bending while using this laptop. VivoBook weighs about 3.75 pounds, which is not bad for a 15.6-inch laptop. Overall, for a $399 price point, I'm extremely pleased with its build quality. Comparing the build quality of ASUS VivoBook 15 with similarly priced Acer Aspire 5, I think VivoBook feels far more premium and more durable. Let's talk about the keyboard. VivoBook 15 has a unique hinge mechanism called ErgoLift that adds a 2-degree keyboard tilt, which helps with creating a more ergonomic typing position for your fingers. It also creates extra room underneath the laptop for improved audio and heat management. So this laptop has a full-size backlit-enabled keyboard. The intensity of the backlighting is user-adjustable and it can be completely turned off if you want to preserve the battery life. The keys are black in color with white lettering, which creates a nice contrast, especially with the backlighting turned on. The keyboard feels very sturdy when typing thanks to its one-piece construction. The keyboard layout is quite thoughtful. For example, the commonly used keys are bigger in size while the numpad and the function keys are smaller. This allows VivoBook 15 to accommodate a full-size keyboard without feeling cramped. The keys provide 1.4 millimeter key travel and they offer an actuation force of about 30 grams. So this creates a nice tactile feedback for a comfortable typing experience. After a few minutes of practice, I was able to hit my top typing speed without any issues. If you are someone who types, you know, lots of emails, creates Word documents, or enters data in Excel sheet, or, you know, if you are someone who do a lot of programming, you will love this keyboard. Okay, now let's talk about the touchpad. So it's not made from glass, but the build quality actually feels quite good. The touchpad measures 4.2 by 2.9 inches, and it has a smooth faux aluminum finish. So the surface feels very smooth to touch, and it lets your fingers glide effortlessly on it. There is no wobbling and you get a satisfying click every time you press the touchpad. VivoBook 15 comes with Windows Precision drivers and it supports all Windows 10 gestures. So in addition to scrolling, you can perform complex gestures like toggling between various open apps, switching between virtual desktops. You can see all your open windows and quickly minimize to desktops. You can use gestures for all these tasks. There is also a built-in fingerprint sensor on the touchpad, which supports Windows Hello. It's really fast and it unlocks the laptop as soon as you put your fingers on it. So I really love this feature. Overall, both the keyboard and the touchpad are quite good, not just for the $399 price point, but for any price point. Okay, now let's talk about the CPU. So this laptop is powered by the 10th generation Intel Core i3 processors. Specifically, it's Core i3-10005G1, which comes from the newest Ice Lake family of CPUs, which are built on Intel's latest 10 nanometer process technology. So this is a dual core processor and it has 4 execution threads and it operates at 15 watt thermal envelope. The base clock frequency is 1.2 gigahertz and the max turbo frequency of this CPU is 3.4 gigahertz. So in Passmark CPU benchmark, this CPU performed really well, scoring 5,243 points. That makes it 24.5% faster than Intel's Comet Lake processor, which was released earlier this year, and 47.3% faster than Kaby Lake R processor, the refresh line which was released last year. So I ran both Chrome and Firefox browsers and I opened about a dozen tabs and I was able to seamlessly switch between various tabs. The processor did not, have any issues. So day-to-day tasks like emailing, web surfing, watching streaming videos from YouTube and Netflix, these tasks you can perform very easily. The laptop just, flies by. I also tried productivity tasks like word processing, data crunching on Excel sheet, and this laptop breezed without any issues. I also did some software development in Python programming language, and I found the performance of this laptop to be quite good. I think whether you are a student who is interested in a laptop for schoolwork or someone looking for a fast budget laptop for casual work, VivoBook 15 is an excellent choice. Now guys, one thing to remember is that VivoBook ships with the dreaded Windows 10 S mode, but you can upgrade to full version of Windows for free. So all you need to do to get rid of Windows 10 S mode is to attempt installing any non-Microsoft software, say for example, Google Chrome browser. So when you do that, you will get a prompt asking, it will say something like, do you want to upgrade to full version of Windows to install this software? So all you have to do is click on the yes button and just follow the simple instructions. You will have full version of Windows up and running in 5 minutes and it's not going to cost you anything. So that's a, that's a good feature. I guess Microsoft knows that Windows 10 S mode is shit mode. So they let you upgrade for free. So I will encourage everyone to do this because Windows 10 S mode, I think it really sucks and I would not wish it even on my worst enemy. Okay, now let's talk about the graphics performance. VivoBook 15 is using Intel UHD G1 graphics. This is Intel's integrated Gen 11 graphics architecture. It features 32 compute units running at a base clock speed of 300 megahertz and a max clock speed of 900 megahertz. So this new integrated GPU, it's significantly faster than Intel's older UHD 620 graphics. So for example, this laptop can easily drive an external 4K monitor at 50 Hertz refresh rate, something which I could never do with, my older Intel laptops, which were running on the Intel UHD 620 graphics. I was also able to play 4K videos on YouTube without any dropped frames or stuttering. When it comes to gaming, I tried Fortnite at 720p setting and I got about 45 to 60 frames per second gameplay, which I think is pretty good. I also tried 1080p setting on Fortnite and I got about 30 frames per second. So it wasn't that smooth, but it was still playable. So that means basically you can play most of the casual games on this laptop without issues. Obviously, this is not a gaming laptop, so don't expect to play, intense games on this. It's not going to be able to perform, but casual games, this laptop is going to work just fine. By the way, this GPU supports the latest version of Intel's video encoding framework called QuickSync. So I ran Handbrake and FFmpeg video encoders and I had no issues with 1080p H.264 video encoding. This laptop actually did a very good job with video encoding softwares. So overall, for the price, I'm pretty impressed with both the CPU and the GPU performance on this laptop. VivoBook 15 comes with a 1080p 15.6 inch Full HD display. The screen delivers around 230 nits of brightness, which is okay for indoor use, but you can forget about using this laptop outdoors because it's just not bright enough. Now the screen is not glossy, instead it comes with a matte finish. The matte finish does have some advantages. It is, it reduces the glares and reflections, which is very useful since, the screen is not very bright. But it also means that the colors are washed out and they don't look very good. Also, the LCD screen is not an IPS panel. It's an older TN panel, which does not offer very good viewing angles. So when this laptop screen is directly facing you, then texts and pictures, they look sharp and videos look good. But if you tilt the screen, the text and the pictures looked washed out. Overall, I'm a little disappointed with this screen. Even though Asus did an excellent job with its thin bezels and almost 90% screen to body ratio, they have compromised on the screen quality. I would have loved to see an IPS panel, but that might have made this laptop a little more pricey. I guess in order to get to $399 price point, every laptop maker has to make some compromise. With VivoBook 15, you get a great build quality, you get good performance, but display is where Asus decided to make a compromise. Okay, now let's talk about the system memory and the onboard SSD storage. Asus VivoBook 15 comes with 8GB of system RAM. This is blazing fast 3200MHz DDR4 RAM, which is great for day-to-day tasks. I had no issues running over a dozen Chrome tabs and seamlessly switching between them. Casual internet surfing, you know, watching YouTube videos and running productivity tasks like word processor and Excel sheet, it all went without a hitch. Now you can upgrade the RAM if you wish to, but remember one thing, 4GB RAM is actually permanently soldered to the motherboard. So there is only one upgradable DIMM slot that is available, and it will take up to 16GB RAM. So in theory, you can actually increase the RAM on this laptop to 20GB. Now I will drop a link to compatible memory module in the video description below if you are interested in upgrading the RAM. Let's talk about the storage. So you get 128GB of PCIe NVMe M.2 SSD, which is again pretty fast and it runs like a champ. It is also user upgradable, so you can replace it with a bigger SSD if you want to. So I will drop a link to the compatible PCIe NVMe M.2 SSD that will work with this laptop. Now to access the memory and the SSD slot, you will have to open the back of this laptop. There are 10 screws and the screws come out easily, that's not the issue. But the problem is that the base of the laptop, it needs to be pried open and you will need a prying toolkit. Now you can get this toolkit from Amazon for like 10 bucks. And I highly encourage that you do get this toolkit, because if you try to pry open the back of the laptop using a screwdriver or something like that, odds are that you will crack the base and you know, then it's going to suck. So spend 10 bucks, get one of these professional prying kit. It comes with everything that you will need, and then removing the back is actually pretty easy. So I will throw a link in the description if you are interested in getting one of these prying toolkits. Okay, now let's talk about the battery life. So this laptop uses an energy efficient 10 nanometer CPU. So that helps with the battery life. I got about 9 hours of battery life during a continuous 1080p video playback at 150 nits of brightness. I also tried PC Mark 10 battery test, which simulates real world usage by running common applications, you know, office applications at regular interval. So with this test, I got around 8 hours of battery life, which I think is pretty good. So this laptop comes with a tiny 45 watt charger, which supports fast charging. So you will be able to charge the battery from 0 to 60% in around 50 minutes. Even though VivoBook comes with a USB Type-C port, unfortunately you cannot charge the laptop using this port. So you will have to use the old school charging port, which is a proprietary port, which means if you are traveling, you will have to carry the charging brick with you. Now, when it comes to thermal management, I think Asus has done a pretty good job with the thermal heat management. The Ergo hinge, it lifts the laptop when in use, so that creates extra room for the fans to suck in cool air and keep the system cool. Now, the Ice Lake family of CPUs and GPUs, they are very power efficient. They are using the latest 10 nanometer process technology. So that, combined with the fact that Asus has used a good heatsink and a good cooling fan mechanism, this laptop actually remains cool even under heavy load, and I was very happy with the thermal performance of this laptop. Let's talk about the audio. Asus VivoBook 15 comes with bottom-firing stereo speakers. They look like typical laptop speakers, but surprisingly, they sound really good. Now most budget laptops, they have very teeny sound, but these deliver quite rich sound. I think one thing that is improving the audio quality is the ErgoLift hinge, which lifts the bottom firing speakers by a few millimeters. And this creates a resonance chamber effect because the audio is actually bouncing from the table on which you have kept the laptop. And that gives it this more rich sound. Okay, switching gears, let's talk about the webcam. So the webcam is very important these days because all of us, you know, we are working from home. So a good webcam is actually a necessity. So this laptop has a 720p webcam, which is mounted at the center of the top bezel, which creates a perfect angle for Zoom video calls. Now, I do wish that more laptop makers start offering, a better quality webcam. 720p, I think, is the bare minimum. I would like to see 1080p webcams as the new standard on all the laptops. By the way, if you want to step up the quality of the webcam, you can always use an external USB webcam. That's what I do. So I will drop a link to my favorite 1080p webcam that can be directly plugged into this laptop, and that is going to dramatically improve the quality of your video in your, you know, video calls and Zoom conference calls. Okay, now let's talk about the port selection. So the port selection on Asus VivoBook, it looks quite good. You get a USB 3.2 Type-C port, which is great, but it only supports data transfer. So that means you cannot charge the laptop with this USB Type-C port, and you can also not use this port to connect to an external monitor. But there is an HDMI port, which does let you connect this laptop to an external monitor. So I have a 4K monitor, and I tested this laptop with my 4K monitor, and I got full 4K resolution at 50 Hertz refresh rate. So that was really nice. Now you also get one USB 3.2 type A port, and you get couple of USB 2.0 ports, you know, the old school ports. Now, in addition to these ports, there is a micro SD card reader, which is great for transferring videos and photos from, you know, your GoPro or any other action camera. There is also a headphone jack, as well as support for Bluetooth 4.1 devices. For internet connectivity, this laptop supports Wi-Fi 802.11ac standard. There is no Wi-Fi 6 support, and also there is no Ethernet port. Overall, I think this is a decent selection of ports, and most of the folks will be happy with the port selection that Asus is offering. Okay, so here are my final thoughts. I think Asus VivoBook 15, it's a great budget laptop. It offers good build quality, it has a solid keyboard and trackpad, the performance is pretty good, the battery life is also pretty good, and the heat management is also done very nicely. I think the only negative is the quality of the display panel, which is not very bright and the viewing angles are narrow. It's not a deal breaker, but I do wish that Asus had given us a better IPS panel. So guys, what do you think of this laptop? What do you guys think of Asus VivoBook 15? Do you think that this laptop should be crowned the budget king, or should Acer Aspire 5 continue to hold that title? So I'm very interested in what you guys think. So please let me know in the comment section below. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please like this video and subscribe to TechnoPanda for more videos like this. Also check out TechnoPandaReviews.com for more reviews focusing on laptops, gaming PCs, and gaming laptops. Again, guys, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.